Today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about education and from a historical perspective. A very important individual by the name of Horace Mann, whose dates range from 1794 to 1858. Now Horace Mann was a Unitarian who believed that the public school system was the means by which the individual could become free. You see, Horace Mann, his vision was that public education or public schools would be the means by which the American student would be indoctrinated into the state. Now, Unitarianism as a religious or philosophical system of thinking is hostile to the Christian faith, which is Trinitarian. Trinitarianism believes in it alone can answer the question of the one and the many, which is more ultimate or fundamental, unity or diversity, the one or the many. The Greeks were never able to answer this question, but the answer is found in the ontological doctrine of the Trinity. As we've seen, Horace Mann, being a Unitarian, believed that, well, think about it. Unitarianism, because it is making the one more fundamental or ultimate over against the many, or diversity, would see the individual's freedom as found in being a good student, a good citizen of the state. So that whatever the political current, whatever political fashion is popular, whatever political movement takes hold upon the people's thinking, that is what the status would gravitate toward. There's no freedom in that kind of system. Only the person who is truly free in Christ, as Christ says, if the Son shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Free, first of all, from your sins, so that you are no longer bound to your sins, but also free, educationally speaking, by terms of the Christian faith, which liberates the mind into the reality of truth. Remember, Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. So any philosophical or religious system, such as Unitarianism, such as that of Horace Mann, the educator, would be hostile to the Christian faith. And this is pretty much what we have today. And through other legislators, through other educators like John Dewey, who was born in 1879, and people like William James, these individuals carried Horace Mann's thinking a little further, and that's where we're at today in the public school system. We have values clarification, values of everything is relative today, that absolutes have been thrown out. Man is an animal. So we have evolutionary thinking that's just taught as doctrine and truth rather than the doctrine of creation, which is found in the Bible. You see, Christian education takes as its basic presupposition the Bible. The Bible alone in its entirety is the infallible law word of God. Horace Mann didn't believe that. Horace Mann believed that man is basically a product of evolutionary thinking, and he opposed, even though he might have been a professing Christian, because being a Unitarian, he had wrong concepts of God. I mean, these men like Ralph Waldo Emerson and Henry David Thoreau, they were also transcendentalists. They opposed Calvinism, historic Calvinism. They thought that man was basically good. And that's basically what you have today. Most modern school teachers, I would say a large percentage of them, are democratic in their thinking, the political perspective. And in their theology, they believe that man is basically good. Man becomes corrupted through his environment. You see, this is environmentalism, in a way. That man is basically good or innocent, but becomes corrupted or sinful or depraved or bad because of the bad influences around him. Again, totally contrary to the scripture. Because the scripture teaches that man was born innocent, but he sought out many inventions. Man was born upright, but he believed the lie of Satan And therefore he died just like God said he would die. The day you eat the forbidden fruit, you shall die. And so this is what we call original sin. Original sin is held by the Roman Catholic Church and Protestants alike. There's one Protestant group, however, the Church of Christ, which denies the doctrine of original sin. And this teaching is heretical, and it's known as Pelagianism. Pelagianism, or semi-Pelagianism, which is really Arminianism, teaches that man is not really that bad. He's not totally depraved, he's only partially depraved. And so, a lot of emphasis is placed upon the potential of the individual, the great things that man can do. Well, that's a faith that's contrary to biblical faith, you see, because we can't do anything, Christ says. You can do nothing without me. Christ says, I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abides in me and I in him, the same brings forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. That's what it says in John 15, 5. Anyway, getting back to Horace Mann, we'll have more to say about this and other educators in the future. I hope you enjoy this. Something to think about. Incidentally, an excellent book on education for you who may be educators or who are interested in the philosophy or history of education, I would recommend a book by a man named Dr. R.J. Rushdie called The Messianic Character of American Education. The Messianic Character of American Education. I think the title is very, very telling and revealing, isn't it? Okay, so that's it. Hope you enjoyed this, and until we meet again.